The next group of drugs that is called as diuretics. Diuretics is a different chapter in your syllabus. Though you should remember, diuretics means which increases the urine volume. Urine is a body byproduct which is producing from our, what is this, filtration of the nephron. Nephron is filtering and directly the blood is going for the filtration. So blood from that, the filtrate, it will come out and it will produce the urine. So if automatically urine will increase, the formation of urine will increase, definitely the blood volume, it will decrease. This is the motto we are using diuretics in the treatment of hypertension, because the blood volume, it will decrease means there is a chance of decreasing your tension, means pressure, blood pressure, it will get fall down. Same things it is happening, but this is going to change the hemodynamics of your body. So you cannot use this particular drug in the patient who are having nephron issue or kidney issue. So if you are having, if the patient is having nephron or kidney problem, renal failure, renal impairment, they cannot be treated with diuretics drug, because at that time it may cause fatal issue in that particular patient. This drug diuretics, different types are there, thiazides are there, furosemides are there, spironolactones are there. They are having different mode of action. Actually, what is that mode of action? They are acting on different portion of the nephrons. So some are acting on the glomerulus, some are acting on the loop of Henle spironolactone, and some on high ceiling diuretics, means spironolactone is high ceiling diuretics, furosemide it is a loop diuretics. So this particular different on their different mode of action, actually how they are acting on different locations, but ultimately they are increasing the urine secretion, that's all. So by this way, diuretics is acting as a anti-hypertensive drug. Next is beta blocker. In previous day I told you, adrenergic, if you are going to find out, it's acting on, or it's binding on two types, two receptor, alpha receptor and beta receptor. I told you previously also number of times, alpha is a, most of the cases in heart we found it's produce arrhythmia, and beta, it increases the cardiac activity. So here what it will happen, the beta blocker, if you are going to give, the cardiac activity, it will get minimized, means the rate of contraction, the force of contraction, it will decrease. So if it will decrease, definitely the cardiac output, it will also decrease. So ultimately we are going to find out the action, that is the blood pressure will be normal. But remember that here, that blood pressure means beta blocker propranolol, it's not going to give you a instant action. Propranolol, it's required sometimes to bring back to the pressure to the normal range. Immediately it will not produce, immediately it will not do that activity. Propranolol, it is directly acting, means it is a beta blocker. Beta means we have already seen that heart activity, what it is, beta's activity is to increase the all the activity. So beta blocker means definitely it will decrease the activity. Okay, it will block, means your rate of contraction, force of contraction and cardiac output, it will come down. So these things is going to produce by beta blocker. It is the heart activity. But even whatever that isoprenaline it is going to produce, and whatever that adrenaline it is going to produce that activity, means isoprenaline it is going to relax or dilation activity on the blood vessel, and adrenaline it is having the constriction activity, both it is going to get inhibited by your beta blocker. Okay, so this beta blocker will inhibit this activity. So beta blocker actually don't have any activity on your vessel directly. So if you will give beta blocker to a normotensive patient, it will not reduce the blood pressure. Only in hypertensive patient, It will reduce the blood pressure. But in which method? By decreasing the cardiac output. If that also, if you are giving propranolol to a patient, initially it will increase the TPR, total peripheral resistance, it will increase. That's why immediately after administering beta blocker, you cannot find the your desired action. It's required 2 to 3 weeks of time to show the exact result. It's required time. But this is a very safe, very good drug for the long run. Because hypertension treatment, mostly in the most of the patient, they take full long time treatment. So for that purpose, the drug should be very adaptable and very safe. So one of these best example is this propranolol. Alpha blocker is prazosin. Here it is going to block the alpha because alpha produces the vasoconstriction. So if it will block that, this particular action, it will get blocked and automatically there is a relax of your vasodilation. Means it will produce the vasodilation. Means the blood pressure will fall down. But beta is not going to produce the action directly. Once again I am telling, that is a reversal, re-reversal of vasomotor tail. Okay, so this action is different. Central sympatholytics, that is the methyl dopa, we are using in the treatment of hypertensive, and vasodilators, remember that this particular methyl dopa, how this is acting, this is a dopaminergic drug, but it will go and it will bind with the receptor in your brain. Along with that, it will inhibit the secretion of noradrenaline. Noradrenaline secretion, it will get inhibited, means what will happen? Automatically the vasoconstriction will get blocked. There will be less vasoconstriction. So the blood pressure will bring back to the normal. And that is the vasodilation. That is example is sodium nitroprusside. Sometimes we are using this drug also. So these are the major classifications of drugs we are going to find out in the treatment of hypertension. Once again, remember that hypertension, it is a situation, it is ever manageable by using these particular treatments and along with some exercise and maintaining your food habits. So both clinical and non-clinical parameters will be followed together to maintain the hypertension. So it will be easily controlled, and if it is not treated in the very beginning or in the perfect time, it may cause some serious effects. We are going to find out in the next classes, like angina pectoris, myocardial infarction or cardiac failure. All are the sub-products or byproducts, which is going to start from this beginning cause, that is the hypertension. Okay, so take care for today's class. We'll meet in the next.